Hey guys, so you might be wondering why I'm not wearing any makeup. Well, actually, I'm not wearing any eye makeup. I want to do my everyday makeup look, and let's get started. Ooh, sorry, I just like pushed my camera. So the first thing I always do, well, I don't always do this. If my skin is having a really bad day, I'll put on the Stila tinted moisturizer, in Fair. I absolutely love this stuff. It is amazing. And that is for the days that I don't need much coverage and my skin looks really dry. But then for those days that, you know, I want more coverage and I want a matte skin, I will add on the Maybelline New York Mineral Power powder. I love this stuff. I've repurchased this like a lot. And so I'm gonna start. Make sure I only put this on my troubled areas, like my T-zone and under my eyes. And I make sure to blend it in a lot. I don't put on a lot. So, especially with powders, make sure that you, because fat powders are super fine. And it's really important not to put on too much, or else it'll like cake into your. It'll go into your pores and your like if you have wrinkles, it'll go into your wrinkles and just make you look even like worse. And so to make sure that you get that all blended in. So that's after if I have any more redness and stuff, because I already applied my Stila tinted moisturizer. Okay, and then the next thing that I do. I start off with a primer. I will either use the Urban Decay primer, or I have been getting into, I really like this Tarte primer. I got it. It's with a True Blood kit. It's my older sister's, but she never uses it. So yeah. So I put the primer on my eye, put it all over, and I like this primer because it really makes your eyes even, like the coloring even in your eyes, and pat with your ring, your middle finger or your ring finger preferably, because that is one of the more weak fingers, or like your pinky. What is on my eye? Or like on your pinky, so you're not like poking your eye out. Okay, now that we have that done, basically all I do with my eye is taking a, here, I gotta move the camera. From the Tarte True Blood palette, taking this, it's like a brown champagne-y color. We take that, and oh yeah, I do like my tripod setup. We take that on a blending brush and get that, and then just put that in your crease. Make sure you tap off all the excess and put that in your crease. This is my favorite crease color because my eyes, when I put in a color in the crease, it gives my eyes, it gives the illusion that I'm wearing makeup there, and it's just really natural looking. And with my skin tone, I really like this color. So find a color that's good for your skin tone. I mean, I have fairly pale skin. And then I wing it out a little bit. Okay, so that is my eyeshadow. That's like all I do. Or some days I'll apply the Benefit Birthday Suit. I love this stuff so much. Okay, but then a lot of the times I will use a liquid liner. This is the Wet n Wild liner. It was super inexpensive, and it is in 898, and it's a dark brown. Okay. And then I actually have a method. So basically, the way to get the best eyeliner, like liquid liner, I've practiced this a lot, is like you rub the brush around the outside, or like this is how I found that. And then taking the tip, I sort of dot it, starting with the middle of my eye, and then I just connect the dots. I feel like it's a lot easier for me when I do it. If I have like my elbow down, I have to sneeze. Okay, we're good. And if I mess up a little bit, that's okay because I have eye makeup remover. Okay, so I let that, the only problem I have with this is it needs a little bit to dry so it doesn't crease over when I open my eye. So I fan that. I think that'll be good enough. And then I did the same to the other eye. I typically do a fairly thick line of eyeliner on the top. I mean, besides the minimal eyeshadow that I have, that's basically all that I have. So I gotta make sure that that dries just to save time. One takes about 30 seconds. And then if I need to touch up, I'll touch up. But I think that looks pretty good. Now I take my Bad Gal Lash Mascara, and before that I always curl my lashes. I find that if I curl my lashes that they don't clump as much. I feel like this is really like creepy. And then I apply a generous coat of my Bad Gal Lash on the top. I am a mascara and eyeliner junkie. I use so much. And like for a long time I used, like I would curl my eyelashes so much, like my eyelash hair would come out, and it was really bad for it, so my dad took away my eyelash curl. I mean, it was a good makeup call. Okay. And then what I typically do, I put on a black eyeliner just a little bit right here. I typically don't go out very far. If I have a heavier eyeliner on the top, then I even it out by not having a heavy eyeliner on the bottom. And then give that a little bit of mascara. Because I'm explaining it, it takes longer, but like typically in the morning, it only takes me like 5 minutes to do my makeup. Okay, and then we're just about done. The next thing that I do, I take my bouncy blush in Hot Tamale. Gotta get it open. Ah! I take my bouncy blush in Hot Tamale. And I just take my finger and I dab a little bit on my cheeks, just right here. I don't go full out on my cheeks. I just go on my cheekbone and I stay in that little range. And then what I do, actually it's sort of weird, but I take my Sonia Kashuk Flamingo. And then I take a stippling brush and to give that airbrush like blushing effect. And I start on the outside and then I lightly go in. So there's more on the outside than there is on the inside. Because I blush from the outside and it's sort of weird. And then I'll apply a lip balm, but I don't have that right now. It's actually being used as my tripod, but that is basically my everyday makeup look. And I don't really do brows a lot because my eyebrows, if you can see, aren't in the best condition. So I think people would know if I was like doing my brows and stuff. I mean, I want it to look natural and I do this pretty much every day. And I hope you enjoyed.